the like 2 days that I had met him, we like played football together, and like it was I remember Halloween, like he was Where's Waldo, and like we went out and it was so much fun. And immediately, like, I knew he was like a really chill guy, like so much fun. And when we were playing football, like we were playing tackle football, and I was like, guys, you can tackle me, like it's totally fine, I don't care, like whatever, I'm here, like let's just play tackle football, don't change your game because I'm a girl. And Paul like refused, and I was like, Paul, just tackle me, like just tackle me. And so at one point he like grabbed me and like gently like laid me on the ground, and I was just like, this kid's a good guy.
It's tough to think how close we actually were, how similar people we actually were. People actually would always come up to me and Paul and ask if we're brothers. Partially, I guess, because we look a little similar, but mostly I think because of, you know, how similar we were and like personality-wise. It's really tough to think that I probably won't meet anyone ever again that I was so close to and have so many similar interests. And but I guess that just kind of shows what kind of person Paul was. He was one of a kind, and words can't really describe how much I miss him.
I think Paul had a lot of strength, especially at such a young age. He was going through a ton of, you know, different treatments, and somehow, like, throughout the whole process, he always had a smile on his face, and he never let the cancer define him.
Paul really taught everyone who knew him how to be a positive person and to really be kind and generous and sincere, and he was honestly one of the most genuine people I have ever met.
One of my favorite memories of Paul is when a group of friends came over for a campfire and I volunteered to make him a s'more. My brother had just bought a pack of edible crickets as a joke, and I put one of the crickets in the middle of his s'more and didn't tell him. And as he was eating it, it was hilarious because he kept saying how great it was, like only good things about it. And at the end, we told him we put a cricket in his s'more, and instead of getting mad or grossed out, he just thought it was hilarious and thought it was a great joke.
It was like the first 2 weeks of school, so I didn't know anybody still, didn't know anybody in the class. And I walked and I like sat down and I was just like waiting, hopefully someone would sit next to me so I wouldn't be sitting there alone. And this boy like walks in, he's just like, hey, anyone sitting there? I'm like, no. And so he sat down and we started talking, and he's like, wait, before we can be friends, like, do you like the Eagles? And I was like, yeah. And then since then, that was just kind of like our clicking moment.
One of my favorite memories of Paul is back from middle school. At the time, he was dating one of my friends, and I was invited to sleep over at her house for a birthday party. And at one point during the night, he stopped over at her house to surprise her with some of her favorite flowers. And it was one of the sweetest things that I've ever seen someone do for someone else. So that's something that I'll always remember Paul for, among so much else.
Oh, I think he changed everybody's life who met him, and I think it's hard to say just how, but he had an impact. His positivity, it was incredible and inspiring. He was so inspiring.
I remember back one summer, a group of our friends had rented a beach house, and we decided to go to the boardwalk for dinner one night. And we all got our food, and upon entering the boardwalk and leaving the restaurant, we were just flocked by a group of seagulls, just attacked. And everyone ran for cover except for Paul. He was determined to stay out in the open air and fend off the seagulls and stand up to them and enjoy his French fries. And his determination was reflected in silly moments like that, but also in his battle with his sickness. It was really impressive, and I strive to be as determined as Paul was.
And then we eventually got to this bridge over this little creek, and I told Paul, I mean, I totally made this up, but I heard it somewhere. I told Paul that if we ran across it and held our breath, that if we made a wish at the end, it would come true. And he was like, we should totally do that. And I was like, yeah, we totally should. But we underestimated how long the bridge actually was, so almost fell down at the end of that. But he went ahead of me, and he was gasping for air at the end. He was like, dang, that was a lot harder than I thought. And he was like, okay, now your turn. And I ran across and I let out my air at the end. I was like, oh, I almost forgot to make a wish. And like, we would have had to do it all over again.
I first met Paul during freshman year orientation when we helped each other move in. And we were sitting in a circle and we had to tell each other our names. And we met a girl named Maria, and Paul got so excited because he was a huge Hey Arnold fan. And there was this scene in Hey Arnold where one of the characters yells at a girl named Maria, and he thought it was the funniest thing ever. And every time he saw this girl in our hall, he would go, "Hey, Maria!" And he thought it was the funniest thing. And every time he did it, he would just laugh to himself. And we would all laugh with him. And he just had this way of like brightening the room every time he walked in. And that's the impact he left on me, is that he just had this genuine spirit about him. And every time I saw him, it would just, no matter what I was feeling, no matter what kind of day I was having, I would see him and I would feel better, because he was just that kind of person that could make you feel that way.
There's so many memories that come to mind whenever I think about Paul, but I think the one that stands out the most is just his belief and his trust in his friends. I know whenever we were hanging out or playing pickup sports or whatever, just goofing around, I would always try and do something crazy or something clutch, and I'd go up to him and I'd be like, "Hey Paul, do you believe in me?" And we'd do this little bro shake, and he'd give me this head nod, and he'd be like, "I believe in you, go out and get it done." And there was one point in my life where I kind of gave up on myself. I'm a musician, a songwriter, I just stopped writing music, I just gave it all up, and Paul saw that and he sat me down and he's like, "Why would you ever do this? You know, you always have to believe in yourself." And the last time I saw him, he was in a state where he couldn't talk much at all. And when I said goodbye to him, he gave me that bro shake, and he, you know, nodded his head. He looked right in my eyes, and he didn't need to say anything. I knew exactly what he was thinking. He was like, "I believe in you, you know, go out and get it done, no matter what you do." So, you know, whenever I'm having a tough time, I like to think of that memory, and it's nice to know that he'll always believe in me. And he always believed in all his friends. And that was just, you know, the greatest thing about Paul.
So the first time I met Paul was fall of my freshman year. We were both rushing APO, and we had to go around the room and say what our favorite, or like our most ideal service project would be. And he was the person right before me, and he said that he wanted to put on a 5K, possibly in Gettysburg, because he thought it was so beautiful. So, of course, when it got to me, that was the exact same thing that I wanted to do. So, when everything happened this summer, it made sense to put a 5K on. But he's my inspiration on a daily basis, and I don't think I've taken off my bracelets since, because anything is possible.
So that's kind of immediately like the impact that he had, that I knew that he was just a really, like, good person.
Paul was one of those people that you'd see on campus, and he'd always have a smile, and he'd always say hello and ask you how you are, which is really special. Not a lot of people do that.
And he was just like really genuine, and he always cared about everyone. And so he would always ask me like how I was, but I felt like he really meant it, and he was interested.
Paul was just like the perfect human. He was the perfect specimen. He was caring and respectful.
I think of Paul, I think of love, I think of strength, of warmth, and most of all that sometimes the littlest things are the most important.
He would just like bring your spirit up, he would make you laugh. He wasn't really afraid to do something that made himself look ridiculous.
He made such an impact on me, and he made me so happy every waking minute of every day. I know that's like really dramatic to say, but he had that special thing that really hit home for me.
How he would just walk into a room and just light it up with his energy, and just how much he cared about everyone.
He really wanted to know like how your life was doing and like what you needed help with, and he's just an amazing person who had a fantastic outlook on life, and I'm really, really lucky that I got to know him.
Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
And anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
And anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
Anything is possible.
brother. There's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.